KOKO with my first YouTube video. I used to make Instagram videos that was like 60 seconds long. My Instagram and all my social medias will be linked in the description box below. You can go check those videos out and follow and comment, you know, and like, you know. As you know, it is Pride Month. And what better way to convey that I do support than to do what I do best, and that is my art. Like, comment, and subscribe. Turn on that bell so then you know when I post, and you can like, comment, and subscribe some more. So if you want to see how I achieved this video and how I went crazy while achieving this look, because I did go crazy, or if you would like to see how you can possibly achieve this look, then keep watching. Let's get to the video. Let's go. So to go ahead and start off with this look, I already did my eyebrows. Right now, what I'm gonna go ahead and do is to go ahead and use some Carmex just so I can moisturize your lips. I'm using the Mario Badescu skincare thing. I'm gonna wipe off the concealer from under my eyes. That's just to get a nice clean base going on here. So now all I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go ahead and take this white eye pencil, and I'm just gonna use that as a base, as if I would use it for like concealer. So all I'm gonna do is just start to basically just color. It's a little NYX pencil. Don't need nothing too special, but this does hurt. So I would recommend just using an eyeshadow base. But I looked at this and was like, you know, well, I'll just use this. Not realizing how much this is gonna hurt. This hurts. Okay, just gonna get that up in there. We're gonna bring it all the way to the top. Might mix in a little bit with the concealer, but I mean, it's all alright. It's all cool. I'm just gonna try to get it as white as possible. What I learned is that when you're doing poppy colors, it's good to use a white base instead of like a concealer or something. Pretty hard. Put this something else. So now that I have that done, now that all the pain is over, now we're gonna just get into doing these eyeshadows, baby. Let's get it done. So we're gonna take the James Charles palette. I'm gonna start with this pretty, pretty red right here. I'm gonna use the light side over here and the dark side over here. Look at that pigment. See, that's what the white base does. It just does what it needs to do. So I'm just gonna pack it into here. And I'm not gonna really move it up to the top too much. I'm just gonna kind of pack it up in here because I don't really want it to be at the top a lot. We're just gonna slowly work our way up. But if you do it the way that I'm doing, where I just kind of just glide it a little bit and pat at the same time, it'll create that little ombre effect with the white. So it's not like a super harsh red. So I'm pretty much done with that red. This is pretty like really light, vibrant pink right here. I'm gonna do a pink color on this side. So all I'm gonna do is just lightly do exactly what I did with the red. And as you can see, that pigment is there, sis. It's there. Slowly just work it in to my brow bone. And it's only gonna be four colors, so I don't really have to do too much. Continue to apply those colors and make sure that this time you are blending in the pink with the red, kind of like one color fading into another. So now that I feel like that is definitely blended enough, I'm gonna switch palettes. This time I'm gonna take the orange from the Zulu by Juvia's. I'm gonna take this pretty light orange up here and start to fill it in front of the pink. When you do blend in these colors, they will make their own little middle color. So we're gonna also take this pretty yellow from the Zulu palette. All I'm doing is just kind of just feathering it. I'm just gonna go ahead and start on this side. I'm gonna take this pretty purple from the Zulu down here. Then I'm gonna do the same as I did with the red to make sure that it's definitely blended out. They ain't finna be ready. Like, they ain't finna be ready. They ain't finna be ready. Hold on. Ding dong. Now I'm just gonna go ahead and take this blue that's in this palette. Pretty kind of ocean blue. I adore, I gave you everything was mine and yours. I want you to live your life, of course. But I hope you get what you dying for. Be careful with me. Mm-hmm. I need to stop playing around. Hanging my life together. Just try to blend it in and make it work. And do the do, boo. Look at them colors. I hope that y'all are seeing this pigment and just looking at it like, she doing too much. Really hope that y'all see this pigment. Like, this pigment on this look, on my eye, over this white, it's just so pretty. So proud. Okay, let me get out of my feelings. So now I'm just gonna take this pretty green that is in the James Charles palette. This pretty green right here. All I'm gonna do is just work it just like I did that orange. This is a really light color and I'm just gonna kind of just fan it on there. Fanning that pretty, pretty green on there. Making it to be something so grand that you don't even have to worry about it. But anyways, just gonna continue to blend. Blend, blend, blend. Oh my God, you know what that reminds me of? That movie Shark Boy and Lava Girl, when you be like, dream, 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 something, something, close your eyes. When I tell y'all, I used to be up in there thinking that I was actually up in the movie. I was crushing on Shark Boy and I wanted to be Lava Girl. You know what? I'm gonna figure out the lyrics to this song.
Disney Channel. When birds with different feathers work together, and that's how we deliver a baby. Tops Friday at 9 on Disney Channel.
Close your eyes, shut your mouth.
Dream, 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 dream.
Just relax, lay about, pour my face to put you out.
Dream, 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 dream.
Keep your time, up your work, there's darkness in the air.
Hey, back to the topic. All we're gonna do is just take this pretty yellow that we use for the other eye. Look at this blend, guys. Just look at this blend. I'm going to take this shimmer color and MAC. It's a white shimmery color. Fine brush, take a brush, take it out to lunch. Take that shimmery color and all I'm gonna do is take it, just kind of create its own little personal cut crease. Gonna pat it on here. So yeah, I'm just gonna continue to get her done. Continue to pat this color on there. I'm gonna go ahead and start doing the eyeliner, but I like to use tape. Just cut off a little piece, kind of depending on how long that you want your eyeliner, and then you just go a little bit. So I'm just gonna put this on my eye. This is in the color black. It's the gel liner by Tarte. I'm gonna use this angled brush. It's mommy on this sweater, mom spaghetti. And there we go. And now we're just gonna take another piece of tape and basically just do the exact same thing that we did with this eye. I wanted to line up with the other one. Just start from the middle to kind of get that shape going on. Now I go to the front and I just kind of fill it in. And you can go ahead and just put on your eyelashes. I'm gonna go ahead and use this glue. I just got it from like the beauty supply. That I was talking about with the eyeliner. And I'm just gonna go ahead and get with the other eye. Well, F is for friends who do stuff together. U is for you and me. N is But anyway, anywhere at all, right here in the deep blue sea. Okay, I'm gonna go ahead and do my face, but I am actually going to skip that part. So I did do my face. Okay, so now what I'm gonna go ahead and do is I'm gonna go ahead and start doing my waterline. I wanted to wait till I was baking to kind of like multitask with it. Same white pencil that I used earlier for my eyelids, this one right here. I know some people do not like looking at people basically messing with their eyes, especially like their waterline and stuff, but I have to do that in order for this look to come together. So what I'm gonna do is I'm just basically gonna put this white liner on my waterline. Just to open this look up and make it look really, really, really pretty. So, I got my waterline together. Now, basically, what I'm gonna do is I'm going to take these colors over here, put them on this side, and then take these colors over here and put them on this side. But I'm gonna put them at the bottom, like where my waterline basically was, but just like right here. So, to start off, I'm gonna take the purple that I used from the Zulu palette. All I'm gonna do is just gonna put that purple at the end like so. So now I'm gonna take that blue that I used, and we're just gonna put the blue next to the purple. So now I'm gonna go ahead and take that green that I used. And then last but not least, I'm gonna take that yellow. It's basically just this put over here. And I'm just gonna do the exact same thing with the other side. I'm connecting this yellow that's up here to the yellow that's down here. Okay, I'm pretty sure that I'm done baking, so I'm gonna go ahead and wipe this powder off. So now is the final part of this look, and that is the highlighting and the lip. So for the highlighter, I am going to use the Bretman Rack Babes in Paradise. I'm going to use this color called Mahu. Right here, and this is probably my favorite one on this palette because it's like so pigmented, it's so cute. And this is the brush that comes with the little palette brush, and I'm just gonna go ahead and put on my highlighter or whatever. Y'all can see how pigmented that highlight is. The highlight, and I just like to like highlight my nose, the top of my lips. And what I like to do is I like to take a small brush, take some highlighter, put it at the very top of my brow bone. The very top of my brow bone. My last part is all I do is just take some eyeliner and put it in my inner corners. And real quick, what I like to do for my lips, I'm going for a nude lip. So I'm going to use MAC lip pencil in the color Chestnut. Just line my lips. That's the human near me. And when I line my lips, all I do, my lips on the outer corners like so. Then all I do now is I take this lipstick by MAC. It's called Half and Half, and it comes out really, really, really pretty. Go ahead and get back to you guys when I take down my hair. I just get it all together so then you can see the final look. See you then, guys. Hi, so as you can see, this is the finished look. This look is very inspired off of Pride Month. I had so much fun making it, even though your girl a little bit crazy. And I hope that you enjoyed it as much as I love making it. I hope that you learned something from this video, or you just probably enjoyed watching me go crazy. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. Go ahead and turn on those post notifications so YouTube can update you when I post again. Thank you for watching with KOKO.